Thought we were getting very profound for a minute there.
Welcome back to Beyond Good and Evil. I'm Slider, and as always, I'm joined by Manga Lover.
Hello.
So, my intention with that was entirely tied to the fact that Paige was still alive. But I decided to do something fun with it. Anyway, we have more of these guards. Double Ace here can help us.
I haven't figured out yet what the title of this game is about. Like, is it named after the Nietzsche book for reasons unknown, or is it...
No.
Just sounds cool.
It sounds cool.
Fair enough.
That's exactly why I put it there. Yeah, let's get rid of these guards with this deck. You're under attack? There's an intruder? What a twist.
Holy shit, I never noticed.
Come on, just get rid of this one last guy. There we go.
Everybody weigh in with your wrenches and your hammers and your glowy staff things. Oh, you just put the boot in.
Just have to go up here and deactivate the tractor beam.
As you do.
What were you hoping for, huh? Everyone you ever loved is already dead. Your mother and father, the pig, and all those little brats.
Pig's not dead.
We sucked them dry of all their fluids so that we could live longer.
Ew.
He's looking for you. He's been on your trail for centuries. Your days are numbered. May the angels of darkness rise to glory.
Oh, hush, you big emo.
What a loser.
He died trying to be more goth.
We have to get back to the base. All the prisoners are still in there.
They're all dead and I have the magic hands.
Is there someone else still alive?
No, there's no one left.
Well, there was, but not anymore. Now there's really nothing left to do but to just head up in there with the ship.
Running, running, running. Bless them for putting save points everywhere.
Now you can actually explore this place, but again, there's really nothing to do. But it is kind of funny. There's just all this water you can explore in the hovercraft. Just for no reason.
For no particular reason.
No.
Landing strip in sight. Straight ahead.
I think if you go too far off base, you'll have the same, like, things as Oh yeah, Liz. So yeah, they have a lot of enemy ships, so that's not good.
And once again, suddenly Star Fox.
But unfortunately, I realized something. And I decided to completely kind of break immersion, because these ships kind of, suck. They suck a lot. Like, seriously. Most of them aren't even trying to attack me. They're just zooming around for no reason.
They're just flying around, just being there.
This should be more exciting than it is.
I mean, they've got awesome music for it, but there's not a huge sense of risk.
Why?
I misread that hard turn as Parker! Like, you're in a spaceship! There's too many of
them for us to handle. No, there isn't. Okay, maybe now they're shooting at us. But when he said that first, nothing was happening to us. Oh, one of them finally hit. Amazing.
Holy shit. Not that it did any noticeable damage, but oh well.
So yeah, we have to get rid of these guys first. Presumably.
We have the support of the people of Hillis, Jade. We'll cover you. Try to get inside the base. We must save those that are still inside.
Okay. You can still shoot them if you want.
Like, if you really wanted to. And I'm sure you would.
Yeah. I love how the ship just goes right through it.
Clipping!
I'm under the assumption that regardless, the ships just respawn at some point. So instead, let's just land. There's nothing left to do but to go down.
Go down and rescue all them heartwarming orphans. They are probably all dead now. Isn't that nice?
Johnny, you have finally come back to me. You have served your master well, Johnny. You alone have brought the Hylians to me.
What?
They have followed you blindly.
Miss Jade?
Dorthgal Parkheim.
Admiral Akbar, what are you doing here?
You are not who you think you are. The pig has hidden your origins from me.
Jake, no! Don't listen to him!
You are the source of my powers, the instrument of my strength. They took you away in the hope of destroying me, but I have survived. Feeding me with only the most miserable of sacrifices. They made you human, but you are not like them. You are mine, Johnny, and I am going to kill the human part of you.
Jade!
Johnny Dom Yandra!
Okay then.
Yeah. Now it's time for the final boss, the Dom's Priest.
Because you are Domes now.
I guess. This part we have to dodge a lot. We can attack, but we're mostly gonna focus on dodging for a bit while I explain a few things. Mainly that, do you remember in the very beginning of the game that I joked that it was the final boss time?
Okay. Because that battle's looking an awful lot like this one?
Not exactly. But that and the boss in the factory, both times I said it was final boss time, right when they showed this guy. So I was never lying. It was, in fact, time for the final boss to show up.
You were just enjoying being a little shit about it.
Yes!
Honestly, I was so distracted by the three-eyed spider monster thing, I didn't notice the big dude with the hands behind him.
Yeah, that's the cool part.
Doing his, you know, evil jazz hands.
Shoot him enough and he'd actually done some damage to him, it seems.
Nifty.
And now he summons clones of Paige. Oh dear.
Listen, will it be difficult for you to stab your uncle in the head? Not even a little bit. Kinda mad at him right now for hiding that I'm an alien, honestly.
Yeah. They're actually just sarcophagus monsters in disguise.
So that makes it okay.
I do love just shooting Paige at him. That just looks so goofy. Oh, crap. Now he took Double H too.
Well, this is all going swimmingly.
Now we have to fight him directly.
And stab him in his horrible, horrible eyes.
Yes. Attacking him in different directions that he appears in. But then he appears from above, and that is very confusing to deal with.
That was a dick move.
And you have to do the whole sequence, or it just restarts, and you have to start all over, like this.
This is like Near Death Dance Dance Revolution or something.
Kind of. Now when he attacks from above, there's two ways to do it. I'm trying to do it probably the harder way, which is to do a charge attack. With your dodge, they don't move over there, then you can attack properly. There we go.
That works. It's got more arms.
And now he's gonna be a dick.
We have to abandon the fight, Miss Jane.
You can tell it's not him because he didn't say Carlson and Peters at the end of the sentence.
And because he didn't hit his head on a thing. I do love when the villain makes fake versions of the main character's friends just to mess with them. What a dick. What a dick. And now here's the real fun part. Because now the controls are reversed.
That is some earthbound shit right there.
Yeah. including... Now we have to do this part again. Reversed.
With the controls reversed. I am so glad you're playing this and not me.
Yeah. This part can be so obnoxious to deal with.
No shit.
And if you try the wrong attack, you'll automatically get hit.
Because of course.
I dodged, but I didn't attack correctly. Damn it. Just need to... Come on! So close. Just... Damn it. Now we have to do it again.
I totally control you, I'm just fighting you now for fun!
Come on.
Finish him! And now a moment of calm with the loading screen. That was pretty. That's where the game ends? Like...
For the most part, yes.
It's just like Shawnee becoming Jesus and bringing everyone back from the dead? Which is
yeah.
Gonna... I've started calling her Shawnee like it's her name rather than Jade, although... Maybe Shawnee is secretly her alien name, like Kal-El or something?
Yes.
I have no idea what they're doing with the credits, but it's kind of pretty.
You'll see what they're doing eventually. But yeah, this was beyond good and evil. What a crazy adventure.
Made by a real shit ton of Chinese people.
Yeah. Made by the shit ton of every people. I mean, to be fair, the Asian influence is fairly obvious at points, so...
Yeah. Well, it's just not... I'll be honest, most video games you expect to see predominantly Japanese names in the credits, and this one has been very much Chinese names.
Also, to be fair, this is a Ubisoft game, so literally everyone ever will be in the credits. Trust me on this. So, what did you think?
I mean, stylistically it was really cool. I mean, I couldn't comment on the controls, but it looked fun to play. Had some really fun, really fun characters, really distinct characters. And there's quite some intense plot twists at the end. It seems to have ended a little abruptly for all the plot twists, but I'm assuming there's some more post-credit stuff that clarifies what the shit, she's an alien? It's kind of like once it starts revealing stuff at the end, it just goes full tilt, everything is being revealed now really, really quickly that you gotta fight monsters now, so don't dwell on it.
Yes. Actually, I just realized. It's exactly like Mega Man 64 was, all the plots just right at the end.
Heh. You just dick around getting pearls and stuff for ages, and then at the last minute, oh yeah, here's all of the plot.
Yes. Now, I absolutely love this game. Like, love it to death. This is probably my 4th or 5th playthrough of it, in general. It's hard to describe exactly why, but, like, it's great mostly for exactly the same reason like Zelda games are great. It just has that right balance of different gameplay ideas and things. And, like, just paced really well. Actually, this game is basically paced better than any Zelda game. Like, it just... like, whenever you do something, it always feels like it matters, and you can get something really quickly for it.
Yeah. And it's also... it's like Zelda, it's got a really broad, detailed, and vibrant world to run around in.
Yeah. Or hovercraft around in.
As the case may be.
Yeah. Though the best part of the game is still the soundtrack. Soundtrack's just fantastic.
Really lovely.
Yes.
The final battle music was really good final battle music.
Yes, it was. It had like this weird bit of techno to it too.
Yeah. Which, you know, works for the heavy-duty sci-fi thing we've got going here.
Yeah.
I feel like now more than ever we need to make heroes out of investigative journalists, honestly.
True.
Please support and protect journalists. Please support them calling the establishment out on their shit all day, every day, using facts. Please. Somebody. Anybody. We'll cling to this alien world where facts mean something.
As you do.
Escapism.
And if you couldn't tell at this point, this... I don't know what the weird thing early on was in the credits, but this is just a showcase through the lighthouse.
Yeah, I got that, which is cute. And yeah, the lighthouse is a really nice setting.
Yes, it is. And maybe a game we'll be doing soon will also involve a lighthouse in some way. Hint, hint.
Woohoo.
But for now, fish window!
Oh, yes. Oh, maybe the stuff really was some stained glass type thing, because, yeah.
Yeah, that's my assumption.
I like how they've even done the stained glass light on the floor, because, yeah, the patterns of light you get from stained glass windows are so nice.
So here's the bad news. Most of the rest of this video is, in fact, the credits.
Exciting gameplay. Brought to you by Mangalove and Slider, all day, every day.
Yes. So seriously, though, the credits in the original game, like, the panning shot of the lighthouse went a lot quicker in the original game. They intentionally slowed it down to add all the credits they could for this version.
All the HD re-release credits.
Yes. Thing is, Ubisoft... I don't know why, but Ubisoft credits are seriously, like, incredibly long. Like, I'm not sure if the... if it's... like, how do I put this? I'm not sure if they have to put all the credits in that they do, or not. Because it really feels like they'll put everyone in the credits.
That's nice of them.
Yeah, it is, but at the same time, like... look, it's going one by one.
They're still here. Yeah, they could at least be scrolling these up and have 5 or 6 different jobs on screen at once, but no. Nope.
Yeah.
Apparently not. That is not what we're doing here.
So, they did finally announce that sequel.
Yeah, I heard.
We'll see where that goes if they ever show more of it.
Ever.
As you could tell, it took so long that the screen started to fade because I hadn't moved the controller for so long.
It'll wake it up.
Yeah.
I'm guessing with a sequel they'd be exploring more of Jade's alien heritage, I suppose, and the Doms elsewhere in the universe, or the Doms coming back to Earth, maybe.
Yeah.
Because you've just taken down this one priest dude, but I'm guessing that's not the entire race.
One of the things I've heard about it, and to be fair, I don't know if this is, like, actually confirmed, but there's a legit source for it, but it's hard to say. One of the ideas for this game that's been brought up is that it might end up being both a sequel and a remake.
Hello?
I know. Basically, one of the ideas I've heard, and it comes from a sort of official source, but it's hard to say again, is that it will remake the game, but continue onwards from after the game, too.
So you have to replay this game, and then you get a new game.
Kind of, yeah. I'm not sure what that means.
Like, if they've done Pokemon Gold and Silver backwards, we have to do Kanto again before we can go to Johto.
That was kind of my thought on what it is, that, like, maybe, like, the first half of this that the new game will just be a remake of this game, but the second half will be a new game. That'd be interesting.
That would be funky.
So we'll see if that's the direction they go or not. Because they haven't even given out a trailer. At least not a new one. There was a trailer way back in 2008.
Yeah, and we can probably assume that's not the most current representation of the game.
No. But I am glad it's actually happened, at least. Because we need more games like this. I don't think, like, many people really do the sort of Zelda pseudo-multi-genre action-adventure thing, really.
Well, it's kind of like, it's the sci-fi equivalent to Zelda's fantasy, basically.
Yeah, pretty much. Like, everything's gone more towards, like, the Skyrim route or something like that.
Which, you know, it's not a bad thing having sandbox worlds. They also can be, you know, just really detailed, really living.
Yeah.
But it is nice to have a strong storyline to follow.
Exactly. And especially because, like, a smaller world is more allowed to have all the details and places mean something.
Yeah.
And also in terms of, like, the gameplay. Like, I always really love how Zelda games and stuff like that do their gameplay, and, like, how they combine all these different gameplay ideas to make this one big adventure that's just filled with variety and fun. Best way I've been trying to think of how exactly... because I feel like... I do know some people that don't really like this formula. Because, like... and especially in this game, like, none of the main gameplay mechanics are actually, like, that great on their own, to be honest. So, like, the way I think about it is that, like, games like this are, like, a halfway point between, like, a game that heavily focused on one type of gameplay and a minigame focused game. Because you have the game that focuses on one type of gameplay, and that gameplay can just be filled with depth and, like, just a ton of different things to do just with one thing, like a combat-focused game like God of War or Bayonetta. It's all about the combat, but you can just do so much with it that you can have a whole game based on that. But you have the opposite side of things. You have, like, say, Mario Party, where everyone loves Mario Party, but, like, any of those minigames on their own are kind of pathetic.
Yeah, oh, God. That's kind of the whole concept behind WarioWare 2.
Exactly.
You don't want to play any of those mini games for longer than 3 seconds, but it's okay, because you don't have to.
Exactly. So, like, I feel like this is, like, right in the middle of those. Like, they give you just enough of the gameplay they give so that you don't get annoyed, so that the gameplay doesn't get old. Like, the combat in this game is not good. It's, like, super, super basic.
But there's not a huge amount of it.
Yes, you do combat just enough for it to be fun, for the minimalist things they do for it to be fun.
And then you move on to stealth. Felt like the only thing that was overdone, but
yeah.
Maybe it's more fun to play than it is to watch.
It is more fun to play, but it is definitely a bit overdone, and as someone who's recently played one of the recent Hitman games, yeah, you can do a lot more of stealth. You can do a lot more of stealth. Anyway, here's some pictures, presumably from after you'd be the adventure.
Look at this photograph. Cute one of Jade and Paige, though.
And what the hell is on Paige's head?
What the hell is Paige's head?
Have you ever seen that version where they replace, like, most of the lines with, well, like, a bunch of lines with, what is that on Johnny's head? I just think it's hilarious.
I haven't seen that one, no.
It's great.
And, you know, I don't think I've ever seen the music video, so I don't actually know what the hell that is on Johnny's head.
Who knows?
A mystery for the ages.
You could tell the credits went on for a long time because we started talking about Nickelback.
Yeah. Well, they sure have been some credits.
Yeah.
And it is still going. I mean,
yep.
We're not even seeing credits anymore. It's just, oh, no, wait, there's Paige.
Hi, Paige.
Sunset? Or sunrise? I think it's getting bigger.
How are you doing, Paige?
How are you feeling about coming back from the dead, Paige? Well, that can't be good.
You know, I think Ubisoft had a different idea in mind with that cliffhanger. What's the words you would want that would fit what they think about you? Oh, there we go. Yeah. That makes more sense. 2003 video game. 2003.
And it has been 13 years, and we're only now maybe getting a sequel.
Yes. Only now will we figure out what the hell is with Paige's hand.
Are they all going to turn into Doms because she brought them back from the dead? Is my best guess.
I don't know.
But yeah, and we don't get any more details on the fact that Jade is an alien, apparently. That's just where they end it. She's,
yep.
Oh yeah, she's alien Jesus, and she can bring people back from the dead, which is not a power any of the other Doms have expressed. Mostly the opposite. So...
I think one of the popular theories is that they would just find an antidote. And it would be anticlimactic. All that time wasting, and they just need an antidote.
The beginning of the next day, game, good thing we found that antidote for getting turned into Doms. And that's how they start it.
Yeah. I mean, that is actually, there's a good chance that is how it would work, because, like, if you remember, both Jade and Double H did end up, actually Double H specifically ended up with something similar on him after they left the factory, which is why he almost died. And they had to give him the last antidote.
Oh, that's true.
So I would guess that, like, the beginning of the next game would be, like, the search to find antidote.
So Paige will tell you, what the hell, man?
Let me say that again. 2003.
They were really sure they were getting a sequel to that game, weren't they?
Yes. I guess so. I don't know anymore.
That was good though. Like, abrupt ending, but really good looking game.
Yeah.
And now I know what Beyond Good and Evil is, even if I don't know why they titled it that. I feel like I have to look that up now. See if it says anything on the internet.
The only thing I know is that it was originally planned to be called Between Good and Evil. Which would make more sense, I guess.
I mean, aside from the Nietzsche book, it could be named after an Italian-French film from 1977, the cult album from 2001, or a very specific episode of the X-Men animated series.
I go with the latter. Oh yeah, I almost forgot probably one of the coolest facts about this game. I don't think I've brought this up, because I wanted to save it. Michelle Ancel. I think it's Michelle. Mycel. I always want to say Michael, Michelle, because it's a dude, but it's Michelle Ancel, I believe.
It looks like the French name.
Yeah. The creator of this game, his next game was working on the, no joke, the licensed video game of Peter Jackson's King Kong.
Okay, then.
Now, here's the really interesting thing. First of all, I've played that game. It's actually pretty good. It's like this weird take on first-person shooter that then goes to, like, controlling King Kong and beating up dinosaurs. So has that going for it.
Anything that involves beating up dinosaurs generally works out good.
But the really cool thing about that is that, and I knew this because of there was an interview in the game that you can watch. Peter Jackson specifically chose him to make the King Kong game because of how much he liked Beyond Good and Evil. That's actually true.
It's a hell of an audition. Yeah, nobody can find out why it's titled that. Everyone just agrees that it's an incredibly cool name and an incredibly cool game.
Yeah, pretty much. And that probably is the reason, really.
Almost certainly.
But that's just one of my favorite facts about anything ever, is that this bomb of a game, this game bombed, I need to remind you, it bombed at launch, and yet it was played by one of the most recognizable directors in the world. I think that's awesome.
Well, at least you can tell the man has taste.
Yes. And it kind of makes sense. It kind of makes sense that he would be interested in this sort of game, because it is definitely one of the best, try to put the best way to put this, probably, at the time, it was probably one of the best cinematic-focused stories in a game. So, like, it seems like the type, if any game was going to appeal to him, it would probably be something like this, I would assume.
I would say a lot of it wasn't just the cutscene cinematography either. Sometimes the overworld got,
yeah, that too,
had some really nice cinematography.
Yes. And that one chase scene.
Yes. Oh. I felt like it flipped into a whole different game genre there for a minute.
Yeah, it really does. Like, that chase scene really was, like, super, super cool in the 2003. Like, I actually can't think of a game before that did anything quite like that.
The vertical chase scenes?
Like, no, the chase scene, the last Alpha Section's mission in town, where we got chased by everyone.
No, that one was cool. That one was really creative.
I feel like chase scenes in games didn't really happen until around that point.
I remember them being a fixture on the kind of Nintendo 64 games I played a lot as a kid, but never anything like that.
But yeah, at this point, I'm not sure what else to say about this game.
I mean, I've said it looks amazing multiple times, and that kind of covers it, but
yeah
I see how it became so cult, honestly.
Yeah, exactly. It really did. Like, I could think of very few games that probably have like, a more cult following than this. Like, and I'm not counting, like, newer games, I'm not sure that counts, but, like, the only, like, older, like, over-decade-old games that I can think of that really have this sort of, like, niche but huge following would probably be stuff like Earthbound.
Yeah.
Or maybe, like, I mean, it was popular, but, like, DSX comes to mind, the real DSX. Or, like...
See, I haven't heard of that one.
Eco, Shadow of the Colossus, that sort of thing. Like, those type of games that just, like, are clearly way more popular now than when they came out.
No, I can't think of any games that I've heard of as often as this one without actually knowing anything about it until this point.
But yeah, that's all I have to say about that.
We've said quite a lot about it over, you know, 28 videos.
Yes.
And it's still a freaking good game at the end of all those. So.
And now you can listen to the whole soundtrack without worry. Hooray!
No spoilers in the soundtrack now. Yay! We are now beyond good and evil. Because we finished the game.
We're beyond Thunderdome. We're beyond good and evil. There's nothing more for me to say. Let's end this before it just becomes sad.
Thanks for watching.
Goodbye.